JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for June the 10th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar continued trading lower against most of the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian morning Wednesday. It gained only versus Aussie and Kiwi, while it was found virtually unchanged against the Canadian dollar. The greenback lost the most ground versus the Swiss franc, the euro and the Japanese yen. Now, despite the further slide in the US dollar, the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi and the strengthening of the safe havens franc and yen suggest that market participants traded on the cautious side again. Indeed, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that that most major EU and US indices traded in negative waters, with the broader appetite improving only slightly during the Asian session today. Japan's Nikkei, Hong Kong's Hang Seng and South Korea's KOSPI are up 0.06, 0.23 and 0.25% respectively, but China's Shanghai Composite is down 0.43%. It seems that investors continued locking profits ahead of the FOMC decision later today. This would be the first gathering after April, when the committee kept interest rates unchanged at the 0 to 0.25% range and hinted that more stimulus may be delivered if judged necessary. We will continue to use powers proactively until we are confident that the US is solidly on the road to recovery, Fed Chair Powell noted. He also added that economic activity will likely drop at an unprecedented pace in the second quarter, while in recent remarks he reaffirmed the bank's whatever it takes approach, raising speculation that officials may proceed with adopting a yield curve control policy similar to that of the Bank of Japan. Now, however, we don't expect them to act at this gathering. Yes, the Atlanta Fed GDP Now and the New York Now cast models add credence to Powell's remarks, pointing to a -53.8% and the -25.5% growth rates, respectively. But until we get official numbers, we don't believe that the Fed will rush into expanding its stimulus efforts. After all, they already announced an expansion of their municipal liquidity facility on Friday. Another factor which makes us believe that the Fed is unlikely to act this time around is the much better than expected employment report for May. On Friday, the report showed that the US economy added 2.51 million jobs instead of losing 8 million as the forecast suggested, with the unemployment rate falling to 13.3% from 14.9%, beating estimates of a surge to 19.7%. Given that this will be one of the bigger meetings which are accompanied by economic projections, it would be interesting to see what the current view among officials in the wake of such a surprising jobs report is. In our view, the report suggests that the worst with regards to the coronavirus is behind us, but it remains to be seen whether officials will share that view as well. Although we don't expect them to act, we believe that they will stay ready to do so if things fall out of orbit, which combined with a relatively not that worrisome language over the economic outlook may allow equities and risk-linked assets to rebound again as investors restart abandoning safe havens. Paradoxically, a somewhat more optimistic Fed may prove negative for the US dollar as the currency has been wearing its safe haven suit recently. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European morning, we already got Norway's CPIs for May. The headline CPI rate rose to 1.3% year over year from 0.8%, while the core rate increased to 3% from 2.8%. At its latest meeting, the Norges Bank cut its benchmark policy rate to 0%, with officials saying that it will most likely stay at that level for some time ahead. "We do not envisage making further policy rate cuts," Governor Olsen said in the accompanying statement. Thus, accelerating inflation may add credence to their view and allow them to sit comfortably on the sidelines. We get more CPI data for May later in the day, this time from the US. The headline rate is expected to have ticked down to 0.2% year over year from 0.3%, while the core rate is forecast to have slid to 1.3% year over year from 1.4%. Despite a potential slowdown in US inflation, we don't expect market participants to pay so much attention. We expect them to keep their gaze locked on the FOMC decision, which is due to be released later in the day. With regards to the energy market, we have the Energy Information Administration weekly report on crude oil inventories. Expectations are for a 1.738 million decrease after a 2.077 million slide. However, bearing in mind that overnight the American Petroleum Institute report revealed an 8.4 million inventory build, we would consider the risks surrounding the Energy Information Administration forecast as tilted to the upside. As for the speakers, besides Fed Chair Powell, we have two more on today's agenda: EU Chief Brexit Negotiator Michel Barnier and ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.